I am going to tell you a little bit about the atomic simulation environment, which is a Python library, and I'm going to demonstrate how you could do these delta calculations that we have heard about this morning. And then I'll also show other tools from ASE that could be of relevance. So what is ASE? It's a Python library for doing stuff with atoms. And we try to make it simple to use also these other packages like NumPy and SciPy. So we want to fit into the whole Python world. And what ASE gives you is sort of this basic structure, atoms object, where you have some atoms and then you can sort of work with different kinds of tools and other calculators. So let's say you are a Python kind of person and you like to use these tools to build fun stuff. Let's see what's in it for you. So one thing is the ASE is divided into different modules. The main module is ASE, and then there are sub-modules like collections. And one of the collections we have is this one with all the elemental structures. So that's built into ASE. Another module is this utils, where you can find different utility functions. For example, this delta function, if you want to calculate compared to equations of dates. And there's a database module. I'll show you how to use that. And we have interfaces to different calculators. And some of them are, or most of these are interfaces to Fortran codes, and then the Python interface is included in ASE, but other codes have their own Python interfaces. There's also an equation of state module, and workflow management is not something we have in ASE, so there are other tools for that. But of course, you can roll your own system if you want, if it's not too complicated what you want to do. Okay, so let's take this first. There's actually a tutorial on the ASE webpage, which calculates the delta factor. And this is just a fun little toy exercise where we use this effective medium theory, which is very fast, and then we use it for seven transition metals and late transition metals. So let's go through that. Can do it. Well, now it's on my other screen. Okay, here we are. Yeah, so this shows this small utility function here that you can use, and there's also this some examples here. So let's go through this. So you in ASE you can import this EMT potential and the collection, and there's this trajectory object that you can use to write trajectory files. So here we loop over the systems we want, make an empty trajectory, loop over the seven volumes, and get this crystals, and adjust the size of the cell, do the energy, and write the trajectory. And then here we can see how to later read in the trajectory, pull out the volumes and energies, create this equation of states, object, do the fitting, and pull out the parameters. And then here you can write the results to a file. So as you can see, ASE is really low-level tools that you can build on top of. So now I want to go back to my presentation. I'm sorry about that. There we are. Okay, so what do you do if you want to do the real calculation? So now you're not interested in this simple potential, so now you want to use your DFT calculator. So just as an example, we'll call it ABC. So you import that, and now we need to worry about K points. So for example, your script could look like this. You want to have this density of K points, then you convert that to some Monkhorst pack numbers here, and you set the calculator here with this K point grid. And most calculators that ASE interface to understands these two keywords, but there will typically be others that are sort of special to your DFT calculator. So this is what you do to do the real calculation. And then you want to put it into a database. And ASE has a database module. And here every row is really this atoms object. So all the positions are stored. And if you have calculated forces and stress tensor and that sort of thing, it gets written to the row. But then there's also additional things that the computer cannot know about. That's sort of the things that you find interesting. So you could maybe write the delta number that you have calculated. So you would add that yourself as a column in the database. And it's very simple to get started with these databases. It's just, this is sort of the best backend. It's SQLite backend. It's just a simple file and it's built into Python. So you are already up and running if you install the ASE. So it's very simple and it's just a file that you can give to your colleague in an email or something. But if you want to have higher performance, you can set up a server and get some extra performance that way. So now I just want to demonstrate what it looks like. Yeah, so this is what we do where I come from. Every time there's a PhD student or student or postdoc has finished a project, we sort of take the opportunity to collect the data into a database. That's a good time to clean your data and add the columns that you really need to understand the data. And let's just look at one of these examples. So all of these pages are sort of there to make it easy for other students to pick up a project. So there's usually a reference to a paper, and you can download the data file, and then you can play with the data. And then there's a description of the data. And there's usually also a little Python example showing you how to work with the data. You can also, if I can hit the link, here it is. You can also browse the data here on our webpage. So then you can go to each of the rows and see what's there. Okay. So how do you write the stuff to this database? It's very, very simple. So this is your loop. You want to do a lot of calculations. And before the loop, you open the connection to the results database file. You do the calculation, do some analysis, for example, calculate this delta factor, and then you write the atoms and whatever you want extra. So it's very, very simple. So I said that, so let me just show a little bit of workflow, because that's in the title of the talk. So so now we added these four lines here, which is a nice trick. So you can sort of say you want to do many, many systems, then you can take this script and submit it to your supercomputer 10 times, and then you don't want them to do the same calculation. So you can sort of say, I want to reserve a row with this key called name, and the value should be the formula of this object here. And then if that has already been reserved, it will say, it will return an ID that is none, and you continue to the next one. But if you are the first one of these 10 jobs, you get to do the calculation, and in the end you have to remember to overwrite this row with this name, so that now it's actually done. So this is sort of roll your own workflow. And the way you work with the results database is from the command line. For example, there's this ASE tool. It has sort of a subcommand called database. And then you can do simple queries. You can look on the ASE webpage for how these look. And then you can sort of select and look at what you want to look at. And there it's important that you put in something so that it becomes easy to find things. Or you can also browse it via a web browser. But the full power of this comes from doing it in a Python script. You can use the same syntax. So you say for row in database select and then the query. Then you can print stuff like this. But you can also do it with just any Python statement like shown here. So, last slide, you can read more about it here, and we are on GitLab, and of course we are very interested in adding more tools to ASE, so whatever comes out of this workshop might end up in ASE. We are very welcoming, so come and talk to me if you have something you think we should have in ASE. And that leaves 2 minutes for the next speaker.